Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part six of Absolute Value Inequalities, and we do the following two problems on this video. We ended the last video with this. In general, to solve an absolute value inequality in the form absolute value of some stuff is greater than or equal to k, where k is a positive number, we separate it into two different inequalities and we solve this compound inequality. Right? So let's do it on this problem. I promised you that would be our first problem. Absolute value of x plus 5 is greater than or equal to 1. All right, so what do we do? We see what's in the absolute value, and we say this is a greater than or equal problem. So when you have greater than or equal, it's going to be broken up into this or. So first we take what's in the absolute value, which is x plus 5, and we change both of the next two things. We change less than or equal, I mean greater than or equal to a less than or equal, and we write this as a negative 1. And we write the word or. Don't forget to write that word. Importante. Or we just copy this and we don't have to change anything. Just take off the absolute value. X plus 5 is greater than or equal to 1. So I'm just modeling what we did in the previous video. So now we just solve this inequality and that inequality. You can't solve both of them at the same time the way you can with the less than or equal to. So let's see, we could subtract 5 from both sides for this first one. And by the way, when I solve this over here, I'm also going to subtract 5 from both sides, right? If you want, you could write the minus 5, minus 5, that's fine. But you're only really solving one at a time. So this becomes x is less than or equal to, well, negative 1 minus 5, that's the same as negative 1 plus negative 5. So that's negative 6, or what's over here? We have x is greater than or equal to. What's 1 minus 5? That's 1 plus negative 5. That's negative 4. Okay, so this is our solution. X is either less than or equal to negative 6, or x is greater than or equal to negative 4. How does that look on a number line? There's 0. Okay, so here's negative 8. Here's negative 4, for instance. All right, so I want numbers less than or equal to negative 6. Going to the left of negative 6, and remember to use the bracket because it's actually equal to negative 6. Or it could also be the numbers over here, greater than or equal to negative 4. How would I write that answer using interval notation? Okay, I would be going from negative infinity to negative 6, union negative 4 to infinity. So this is our answer to this problem. Now you can check numbers here. Okay, so numbers to the right of negative 4, like you could plug in 0 into your original, right? Here's the original equation, I mean, I'm sorry, original inequality. If you plug in 0, hopefully you could see that's a true statement because you would get the absolute value of 5, which is just 5, which is bigger than 1. Or you could pick a number smaller than negative 6, like how about negative 100? Well, if you put in negative 100 for x, you're going to get the absolute value of negative 95, which when you take the absolute value will be a big number. 95 is also bigger than 1. So you could do a little check like that just to see that you're on the right track. What wouldn't work, obviously, is this negative 5. So what would happen if you plugged a number here that's not part of the shading? What would happen if you put in negative 5 for x? Think about that. You'd have the absolute value of 0. That absolute value of 0 is 0, correct? And 0 greater than or equal to 1, that's definitely a false statement because 0 is not bigger than 1 and it's not equal to 1. So this is our solution right here. All right, here is our next example. Absolute value of 2x plus 3 is greater than 7. Why don't you put the video on pause and see if you could do this one all on your own? Okay. I'm just going to one more time talk about what this really means. It means whatever's in here, right? When I take the absolute value of it, it better be bigger than 7. So if whatever's in here is bigger than 7, it's going to work. That's the one piece, right? That when you write 2x plus 3 is greater than 7 in that OR problem. Or that stuff in there, right? All that stuff in there, when I take the absolute value, I want it to be bigger than 7. Well, if it's a number like negative 8 or negative 9 or negative 10, that'll work too. So if I pick numbers that are smaller than negative is negative 7, that should also work. So I'm thinking about that algebraically, or you could just memorize, of course, how to get this statement, which is how most people do it. But it's nice to kind of understand where this comes from. The other way of thinking about it is the number line. Here's 0, here's 7, here's negative 7. This stuff, this 2x plus 3, has got to be to the right of 7 or the left of negative 7 to be at least 7 spaces away. So again, that's what this is really saying. That 2x plus 3 has to be over here to the left of negative 7, or it has to be to the right of positive 7. Okay, so that's just sort of explaining it, but this is just using the definition, right? Almost, it's, well, the procedure. If you take the absolute value of 2x plus 3, first you just take what's inside and you switch the inequality symbol and change this to the opposite. So 2x plus 7 is less than negative 7. You write the word or, and then you just write this without the absolute value sign. That's the other way you could do it. All right, and so we're going to solve it. So I'm going to subtract 3. I'm just going to write it over here at the same time, but solving one equation at a time. On the left, this first, I'm solving this inequality. That says 2x is less than negative 7 plus negative 3 is negative 10. We'll divide both sides by 2. Get x is less than negative 5. So that's going to be part of the answer. Or, now let's do this other part. This gives me 2x is greater than 4. We'll divide by 2. And we get x is greater than 2. Notice the steps you do to solve each inequality are the same. Notice I subtracted 3 from both sides and then I divided both sides by 2. But you can't do it at the same time. You can only do one at a time. There's no way to kind of put those two together. All right, so there is our solution. X is less than negative 5 or x is greater than 2. Let's just put it in interval notation. Numbers less than negative 5. How do you write that? It's from negative infinity to negative 5 in a parenthesis because it's not equal. Remember, we use the brackets when it's equal. Instead of writing the word or, we write union. And then we pick x is greater than 2. All right, so that means it's got to be numbers to the right of 2. Again, we'll have to do parentheses because it doesn't actually equal 2. And going to the right forever. And if you were going to graph it, let's look back up here at this picture, the number line. It's not to the left of 7 and to the right of 7. That's what 2x plus 3 was. But the actual answer for x is it's got to be, let's see, this is 0, so we're going to the right of 2. Those are the values of x to the right. Whoops, that looks like that's not where 2 is. That's where 1 is. I'll just change where my 0 is. How about putting 0 here? And then we've got to the left of negative 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. And of course, I should label my number line. So I'm just going to say that's 1, 2. I'm going to just say where negative 4 is and 1, 2, 3, positive 4 is. You want to label, I like to label a number on each side as 0. All right, so here's our answer in interval notation. Up there is our graph. These aren't easy problems, and it's hard for some people to really get the idea of distance for absolute value. Some people, the number line approach makes more sense to them. Sometimes the algebraic way. Some people just like to say, "What do I do to get the answer?" But I like to really stress, there's no magic to this. It comes from the definition of absolute value, completely from the definition of it being distance from zero on the number line. And the definition of absolute value, remember, can't be a negative number. So we'll do some more problems like this and work to more difficult types on the next video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.